Hey everyone, we're here at DevOps 2014 and I'm here with Tor, and we're here to talk about, guess what, Android tooling. So
yes.
Welcome, Tor.
Thank you.
You've been covering what's new in Android in a session and Android tooling.
Yes.
And then there's several parts to it. Obviously, Lollipop was just released, but you're working on Android Studio, which is bringing a whole lot of new things to Android developers to the table. So build systems, new features, a lot of new things. So for those that haven't been following, maybe you can recap where we are.
Yeah, so Android Studio is something we announced a couple of years now, and it's a brand new IDE for us, but it's built on top of the rock-solid IntelliJ IDE. So that gives you sort of a very good Java editor and XML editor to begin with. But then we've added some additional Android features to make it, you know, more productive for Android development. And so that's sort of the core IDE that we're building all these other extra tools around. So one of the big changes in Android Studio is that we've added support for the Gradle build system, which, you know, adds a lot of very, very useful features for Android developers in particular. It makes it very easy to, for example, you know, with a single source base, make your app target, you know, have both like a free version and a pro version, or you may want to very easily create, you know, a beta build that you distribute to some users and then a release build for others.
Right.
You can do that sort of very easily.
So the other, obviously, the reason you would want to have this is you can run your whole build outside of the IDE. Not that the IDE is not good, but there's so many more things you can do when you're...
Yeah, I mean, I think it's pretty well recognized at this point that you want to have, you know, build... You want to ship APKs that you didn't build on your system. You want to have it sort of taken from the build server where you're also running your tests, right? Sort of a continuous integration server where the team sort of commits and it runs and makes sure that everything is all right. We had a problem before Android Studio and before the Gradle build system where, you know, we would implement one build system in Eclipse and then we would have another one from Ant on the command line, and so they weren't always the same and it was very difficult to target the same features. So now we've sort of made the decision that there is one build system. It is used both in the IDE and on the server, and that is the Gradle one.
Right.
And then we do all this work on Android Studio to sort of make that work well, so that even though the build system is configured with Gradle files, you don't have to know that. You can sit in your IDE, open up the product structure dialog, and say, I want to add a free flavor, and I want a pro flavor, and I want to use this version. You can do it all graphically.
Right, but if you want to do get you know, dirty and...
And people do. I mean, we see a lot of expert users. So, you know, we talk to people who had, you know, hundreds and even thousands of line scripts to do all these complicated packaging tasks, and they can now just replace it with, you know, small groovy script, and that's, you know, a big win for them.
Right, so that's the point of using Gradle in this case. So Android at this point is at a place where you can target phones and tablets, and you know, if we stick to that parameter for a second.
Phones and tablets and, you know, watches.
Right,
and
we'll get to that.
Okay, okay.
Just phones and
yes.
tablets.
That's only phones and tablets, that's it.
No, but that's a hard job already. So
yes.
What kind of support can you expect in Android Studio to help developers develop for those different form factors? And we'll get to wearables and to other things in terms of visual tooling. In
right.
Terms
so we have
hints or, you know.
That's right. So we have a number of features to help with this. So I think maybe the most, you know, I think easy to understand one is that you can view your layouts graphically inside the IDE. And we have this feature which lets you say, hey, I want to see this layout, but I want to see what it's going to look like in a right-to-left locale and a left-to-right locale at the same time. Or I want to see what this is going to look like across different versions of Android. So you can sort of see both the material look and the hollow look and even the gingerbread look. Or you can say, you know, I want to see what this layout looks like across these different translations. So you can quickly see, hey, this one language, you know, my strings are wrapping. So you can sort of, you know, in Android, it's very easy to provide resources across different configurations, is what they're called. Like, an example of that would be like landscape versus orientation. You can very easily say, hey, this is my landscape layout, this is my portrait layout. And so we make it very easy to sort of view all that and see what happens to your layout across these different, you know, localization, orientation, all that stuff.
Right. So that in itself is really useful features. Though now, of course, if you add to the mix the fact that we have wearables, and the way you develop for Wear, Android
yeah.
Wear specifically, is by either the notifications, but if you want to build an app for Wear, that's an APK that's, you know, bundled in the other APK. So there's a whole build system, and Android Studio helps for that.
That's right. There actually is special support for example, Android Wear and the Android build system. So you don't, and by Android build system, I mean the Gradle build system that we've, you know, extended with an Android plugin. It's pretty easy. With a small set of files, you say, hey, this is a Wear app, and here's some additional parameters. And we will actually build all this. We'll take care of building the, you know, the APK that gets bundled in the other thing. And we have more features coming that makes this even easier to target, you know, different variations.
So, how about other platforms like Glass or
I think those are all sort of the same use case from us. Like the IDE has certain ways of like previewing Android resources. Those can be used on Wear, and we have special support. I mean, I think one of the challenges for Wear is they also have the round form factor, which you know, is sort of just difficult for tools to deal with the fact that it doesn't just like, hey, this is not just a rectangular window. You have to clip it with a circle. But we have support for that. And so I think Glass and Android TV are sort of additional use cases where there's a special module type and a special plugin type, and you just get to act as if it's the exact same type of resource from a usability perspective.
So Android 5.0 Lollipop is shipping to a number of devices as we speak.
That's right.
Anything specific in terms of support in Android Studio for that?
Yes. So there were a lot of new APIs obviously in every release, but in this release there's a lot of new support to deal with animations, and for example there's vectors and there's ripples and all these new things, and you need editor support for that, and we have that, right? So you get code completion in these new resource files. We do XML validation, so if you have a mistake, we'll tell you that. We'll tell you if you are, for example, adding a vector in a resource file that isn't Lollipop specific, because that could be a runtime crash. So we have a lot of support for all the new editor APIs.
So you have a lot of support in terms of hints or whatever you call
that. That as well, yeah. Yeah.
So for a lot of different things, not just Lollipop, so if you add this to everything you already have,
that's right.
Is that the kind of information that could be available and generated in the continuous build, for example, or is that surface only in the IDE itself?
No,
for somebody
some
like
of the features
moving
obviously
to Android Studio, for example, or moving from a different tool chain.
That's right. So some of the some of the features are in Lint, and those run from the command line. So obviously, if you're running Lint in the IDE, you get quick fixes. But if you run on the command line, you get like an HTML report, for example. So you can absolutely get that, in the command line server. Some of these features are obviously going to be IDE specific, for example, code completion. But there's also some of these inspections, which are running only in the IDE. And the reason for that is that they're taking advantage of a lot of IntelliJ specific support that we can't actually run outside the IDE.
Okay.
So you definitely want to actually try it in the IDE as well,
not just from the
command line.
Course.
Even no matter how much you love Emacs and Vi.
So we are talking about an IDE that has not reached 1.0 just yet. So what takes
just yet?
Just yet.
We are getting extremely
about it.
Close. So the current version number is 0.93. Simple math. We're 0.7, away from 1.0. We don't generally want to do it that accurately, but we are now really kind of considering the next few builds release candidates.
So the beta release was back at Google I/O in June, and a number of things changed in terms of, you couldn't allow yourself to have like breaking changes. What will change with
1.0? We've done that anyway.
You've done that
We've added, our goal really for 1.0 was to both be stable and feature complete. And so, we've changed the Gradle plugin quite a bit. Like we've actually changed APIs, which were a bit painful for our users. That meant that, if you were using some of these early builds, you may have to actually update your build files as you got new versions of the IDE. We plan to stop that at 1.0. Like we want to make these APIs more stable, and if we for some reason have to change them in the future, we'll do more work to help migrate, right? But we've also added some new features to address feedback, right? So we have a brand new AVD manager that's going to try to make it easier to set up an AVD, a virtual device that is configured to run fast. So we'll make sure that if you're on x86, we'll use the x86 system image and all these things, right? It was very easy in the past to accidentally set up a very slow emulator, and we're trying to streamline that. And there's a number of other features we've added as well to sort of address our 1.0
so
desires.
I have to say, I'm quite impressed to see how many people are using Android Studio already. So that has to do with the fact that it's built on this rock solid base.
That's right. That's right. I mean, let's not forget, even though it's a 1.0 product, it is built on, IntelliJ version 13.
Yeah.
It's a very, very solid IDE. So I think the parts that we've done that have sort of been, tricky for us is taking an external build system, Gradle, and making that work as the build system in the IDE. IDEs tend to be, I don't want to say control freaks, but that's kind of how they are. Like the IDE knows everything. It knows how to build everything. It knows what changed.
That's the deal.
That is what IDEs do. Yeah. We have deliberately chosen not to do that, to not have one implementation of the build system in Studio and another on the command line. We're saying we're always running Gradle. And so we're working a lot on performance in Gradle to make, we're not quite where we want to be yet. I will be totally honest about that.
Well, it's a 1.0 version. Performance is never really the biggest
and
focus of a 1.0 version. So
that's
maybe
right.
That's
and a lot of try. Editing features are happening without compilation. So, if you're used to using Eclipse, you're used to that, it doesn't update the quick fixes until you press save, because that's when it runs its compilation. IntelliJ does not work that way. It is constantly, the minute you pause, editing, it'll actually go and do its, its checking and highlight errors for you. Building is actually when you want to run.
Yeah.
Yeah.
great. So 1.0 is around the corner. Maybe by the time people see this, it will be out. So certainly go out and check for yourself.
Depends on how, you know, how soon this is, but you know, definitely we're hoping very, very soon.
Okay. Well, Tor, thanks a lot for spending the time.
And, thank you.
People try it out and send feedback.
Yes. Report bugs, please.
Thank you. Bye.